Hello everyone, this is Akash Chauhan, and in today's lecture we will discuss two-way communication in advanced Java programming using sockets. Okay, but before moving to this topic, let me discuss what we have done so far, so it will be easy for you guys to move on to the next topic. So far we have discussed when we try to develop client-server one-way communication, what we require is the client would be writing something over the buffer and the server would be reading out of that buffer using socket only. But at client side, we use socket class, and at server side, we use server socket class. Socket class requires IP address and the port number on which this client wants to connect with the server. And this server socket class is responsible for making this particular port number 8080 activated to receive the connection. So if we don't run this command and send this request, then the connection refuse request or the exception will be there. But if we run this line first of all and then this one, then the stable connection message would be there. Okay, so to write on the buffer, what we need, we need to write on the buffer by the client. We need the permission to write on the buffer. To get the permission, we use this object, and we call this method, and we pass that value into this data output string class. And later on, that object is used to call this write UTF method. With the help of this write UTF method, we can write over this buffer. Okay, and again, write output stream is not enough to read the data. So the another class of the same library, IO library, we use data input stream. Okay, so data input stream is used to get the get the data from the buffer. Okay, for that we use the same object, because this accept method, there is accept method in this server.java which will return this socket detail, and we will have the replica of S1. So that let's say that object is S2 of this S1 dot accept. So using this S2 method, we can call get output stream, not output stream, but input stream. Because in this case, when we receive the data at server side, we need to read the data, not write the data. Okay, we have to read the data. So we use the different method, which is s1.get input stream, right? And we will pass this value to different class, which is not data output stream, but data input stream. So of this class, we can use a method called read UTF. Okay, we can call this method of this particular class by creating an object while passing this as a parameter, the permission. So this is just one-way communication. So as you can see, we use socket for calling this, all these, you know, reading and writing permission. Okay, and even this accept method would return the detail of the socket. It means to even build a one-way communication, we need socket and server socket class. But what will require for a two-way communication? Two-way communication means when the server would also be responding back to the client. So let me reach to that point. But first, let's discuss one more important thing about this accept method. It is very important, as I mentioned in the previous class. It is responsible for three things. First, it is responsible, this accept method is responsible for the wait for the request. It means if there is no request by the client, then the server would always be waiting on this port number. Okay. Second thing, whenever the program would be executing this line, the server would return the client socket detail. Okay, this is the client socket detail, right? And then stabilizes the connection. So whenever you want to write, if this question will come into the exam, that what is the role of accept method, can you define with an example? So you have to talk about these three things in detail. Okay, waiting for a connection, you can add up. If there is no request, then the server would keep waiting. Okay, and it will return the client detail, which later on we will be using for, you know, getting the permission to read and write. Okay, and so this is about the accept method. But in today's lecture, we will focus on how to build a two-way communication. Okay, so what is the meaning of two-way communication? When we have a client and we have a server, and when client sends some data to the server, and server is also responding back to the client with some message. So let's say message one sent by client and message two sent by the server. So it would be great if we can create let's say chat box. If we can create through socket programming and server socket programming a chat box where the client would send some message. Okay, so client would send some message to the server, and server will also respond back to that particular message, and they can chat there. So if we can build that system today, it would be great. Okay, so we will try to develop this chat box today, where the client and server can communicate not just by sending one message, but they can send as long as they don't want to stop the conversation or the chat. So we'll try to develop that. But before developing or writing the code, what we can do, we can understand the steps to achieve that state where the client and server can communicate with each other freely. Okay, so let me discuss those steps. So if we simply talk about this A part, when client is sending something to the server, in that case, first thing, the foremost and the most important thing is the client should send a request. Otherwise, the server would always be waiting. Okay, so when client sends a request, then the second step is server would be waiting for that request. Server would accept the connection. Server would return the socket detail. And the third thing the server would do is stabilizing the connection so that the client can prepare or send the data. Okay, so sending a request is whenever you create a socket object like this. Whenever you call this, whenever you create this object, a connection request for that particular IP address and for that particular port number will be sent to the server. Okay, so when you send a request and simultaneously if you run the server, then the stable connection will be generated. The next step of the client is to prepare data. So in previous example, what we have seen, we have created our own static string, which was, you know, which we have written on the server. But this time we can also see how to write data from a keyboard. Little dynamic way we can explore. Earlier we have explored the static way, how to use a fixed kind of a data. But this time we will make you free to write something from your own side, and that data will be sent from client to server side. Once we prepare the data, then we write that data over the buffer. And which buffer? The buffer which is involved between the client and server, right? So on that buffer, the client would write. Okay, after, you know, accessing the write permission of the buffer, the client can write. And after sixth step, the next step would be the reading step. And how the server would read? By accessing the reading permission. This S is the object of socket, which was written by the accept method. And we will pass this value into the data input stream. And we will get the object out of that. And we can call this read UTF method. So by this flow we can read. But the writing step is, you prepared the data. Let's say you have a dynamic data this time. This is also a string type of a data, but this time you have taken the input from the keyboard. We will see how to do that. Then we have used this data output string class. The object of that class is data write, which whenever you would be creating the object, you will need this permission get output string from the same socket of the socket class of the client side. So you, when you access this data write, you can call the method of this object is write UTF. You can call and you can pass this particular string into this method, and that data will be written to the buffer, which would be later on read by the server side. If you look at it, this is just a, this is the client to server. But what will happen if we try to send something from server to client? Okay, we are waiting for that. So let's understand that. So if client is sending something to the server, then in that case, you need to focus over here only. Okay, so you are reading something. Okay, so let's try to understand that. If client is sending something, okay, if because in this scenario, where is this scenario? In this, the request is generated by the client, okay? And client would be writing something over the buffer. So I'll not count this as of now, but the thing is, I will write the data by the client over the buffer, and that data will be sent to the data read. Data read would be the object of which data input stream, which will call the read UTF. So the one flow is this one. You write something, and here in the server, data read object will be called to call read UTF method, read UTF method. Okay, and this will use write UTF method. And if server tries to send something to the client, then also the data write would use write UTF method, right? Like it has used write UTF. And when this data is sent to the client, it means there has to be a data read object which would read, okay, which will call read UTF somehow and read the data from the buffer. Okay, so we are clear in this particular case. I should tell you that we are taking input from the keyboard, not as a string, but we are not using the static string as we have used in the previous example. In this case, we will use something from the keyboard. It means at the client side or at the server side, we need data read object, data write object, and we also need an object which can write or read from the keyboard. Okay, which can read from the keyboard, we also need that object. At server side as well, we also need such kind of a objects. Data read object to read the data write object to write something, over the buffer, and keyboard read is to read data from the keyboard. So if we try to, build programs, client Java program and the server Java program, then we have to first initialize these three objects, okay? Because in both the scenario, whenever you try to communicate two-way, we need all these objects at client side as well as at the server side as well. So when you try to write, then at the same time for that particular write, you would read at the server. Okay, and whenever you try to write at the server for the client, you would read that data later on at the client side. This would be the flow. Okay, so what we can do if we are trying to develop a chat box. So in chat box, what will be the scenario? Scenario would be like this. Let's understand. If there is a client, there is a server. So client would say hi server, and it will return something in the response of hi. So it will say hello. Hello client. Okay. Then client, I'm just taking an example so you can understand how to build a chat box. Then client would send something, how are you? Let's say, how are you? And that message would reach to server, and server would respond back to, I am fine. How are you? So this is a general chat box, and they can stop whenever they want. Okay. So we have to cover that scenario, that when the socket will be closed. Okay. So it is not actually as it is, as you know, the message chat box we use, it is actually built upon sockets. Okay. We are talking in terms of a raw coding. Okay. So we have to stop this somewhere. Okay. So we can fix a word, let's say, whenever the client or the server would say bye, this chat will be ended and we can close the connection. Okay. So if we want to develop chat box, okay, which will be using the sockets and socket programming, then what is the scenario? You please ignore this, this line. You please come to this point, that if we want to write something on the buffer, if the flow is writing and reading at the server, then if we are writing something on the buffer, then in advance we should have something, right? We should have, so that we can write. So how can we have? By reading data from the keyboard. So this is the first step. Let's say we use keyboard read object to read something, and that data will be in string format. And that data we can write over the buffer, that string over the buffer. That is clear. Okay. And in the second step for the server, we should read that data. And how to read? By calling read UTF method, and this will return the string, and we can print this string. So this is just one way. One way means hi. It will send the hi. Okay. Let's understand. The client would send hello client. So how they will send? Again, you can repeat this particular step here. Okay, here as well. So you read something from the keyboard as a string, and you write that string over the buffer using data write object, and you can then paste this over here. Okay, because after writing over the buffer, so server has written hello client over the buffer, then the client job is to read. So how to read? Data read by using read UTF, right? And then the data would be in string format, and you can print that data. But there is another constraint, that if we want to end this chat, then either of the client or the server, if they write by, or any other choice of word you can use, I have used by. So if I enter, or client or the server would write by, then this connection will be closed. It means we have to stop this chat. So in that sense, what we can do, if this is the string we are using to write, okay, and if we have written by from the keyboard, okay, and if it is equal to the string, okay, this string is same to this. If we are writing by through the keyboard, then it will say you can go inside this chat only if it is not true. So if it is true, it will not go. If it is not true, it means whatever string you are using, it is not equal to by, then only you will be able to chat. And we will same copy paste over here as well. If the server is not writing by, okay, then they can continue. The server can continue sending and receiving the messages. And later on, we can close all the connection. Close all the connection. And we can repeat this particular step here as well. So this would be the two-way communication pattern. Okay, so this is theoretical. Now let's discuss it in a practical way so that we can code it. Okay, so this is all theoretical. So let me move on to the code so that we can relate this thing with the code. Okay, so let me open that. So first of all, let's talk about the client side. Okay, so at client side, what we need three objects. One is which you can read, which will get the read permission. The another one is data write, which will get the write permission on the buffer. And the another object is the keyboard read, which can read data from the keyboard. Okay. So let's understand. So at the client side, we have a socket as usual. We are connecting with that socket and that particular port number, right? And then we are creating all these objects what we need later on. So this data read requires the get input stream permission. It means we can read through this object. We can call read UTF. Okay. Data write object is to get the this. We are getting the writing permission. We are passing those permission into data output stream, and the object of that class is data write, which later on will be used as a write UTF, which will call the write UTF method. Okay, now we will use this BR object, which will be able to read whatever we can write through the system keyboard. Okay, system is the whenever you write through the keyboard, you pass that value into the input stream reader, which will later on be used as a parameter into buffer reading mode. Because why? Because we can call this read line method. If we simply use this, this will definitely also be providing you the string. But what we want to use the functionality of the keyboard is, if we write a line, a proper line, if we can read that whole line, okay, then it would be great. So in order to do that, we have passed this object into buffer reader class, because this BR method later on can call this read line method, okay, which will return whatever you have written in a line using a space, non-space, anything, okay, that will be converted into the string. And later on, we can use that string for our, you know, communication. But this much you should be clear. So, sorry. So we have created these three objects. Okay. First, we need to write so that the server can read. So in order to do that, if we create this while loop, we read something from the keyboard. We write that over the buffer. Okay, this is just the writing operation at client side. I'm sorry. So we try to develop this write functionality. The write functionality is to read from the keyboard and then write it over the buffer. Okay, so what we are doing over here, we are reading something from the keyboard. Okay, and we are using data write object is this one, because it can call this write UTF method, and this string will be written over the buffer. So in this these two lines, what we are doing is we are typing something from the client side, okay, and we are that you know message will be sent or will be written over the buffer by these just two lines. Okay, this is totally okay. And if we have written something over the buffer, then we can flush it. Okay, this is just the only one operation at client side. The next operation will be performed at server side. They would read that, okay, what you have written over the buffer. So they will call this read UTF and print it. So let me open the server program. Okay, just wait. Okay, at the server side as well, as usual, we have called this okay, because we have to activate this port number so that the client can connect. And if this is successful, then it will print this connection stable message. Okay, then again they have created the same objects. You must understand this thing, that both of these client and server have to create these objects, because they both are reading from the keyboard, they are reading from the buffer, they are writing over the buffer. Okay, so look at it. Let me again revise that. The server, whatever you have written over the buffer, the server would read that using the read UTF and print it. Okay, so let's see. The server is calling the data read. Data read is to read, because it is getting the read permission to access whatever you have written by the client. So you use this to call this read UTF method, and it will return you the string, and it will printing that string by saying client is saying so. So these two lines are responsible to read whatever is sent by the client. Okay, so this much should be clear by now. So this operation is done, one and two. One will be performed by the client and second will be the server. Now let's talk about the operation which will be performed by the server first of all, and then will be at the client side, because the same steps what we have done over here will be performed by the server. Okay, so the server would read something from the keyboard, that will be that the server would write on the buffer, and then at the client side we would read that from the buffer and print it. So let's look at those scenarios. So it is the server. Server is reading something from the keyboard. Read line is the method of br, and br is the object of buffer read, in which we are using the keyboard. Okay, so we are reading something from the buffer, from the keyboard. We are writing over the buffer, because data write is to write over the buffer, because it has the permission to write. And what is writing? What we have written, or what we have as an input from the client. And then we are flushing. Flushing is just flushing out the buffer, okay, after writing. Okay, once the data will be at the client side and the client would read, this buffer will be flushed out so that we can write again. Okay, so it is required because it is a chat box. Okay, we need to flush the buffer so that the client can read and write. If the transaction of the data is successful, then we need to flush the data over the buffer so it will be fresh. So if the client wants to write something, or the server wants to write something, the buffer should be fresh. Okay, so this is the step at the server side. If we have written over the buffer, then the client would read it. Okay, and how to read it? Using the data read, read UTF, and whatever you are coming as a string, that it is server saying. So it is saying that server says it is S2. So without any further ado, let me run both of these programs, so then we can understand how we have developed. Okay, one thing I forgot to mention, that if either one of the client or the server, if they write by, okay, so it will not go inside this, because it's a while loop. If it is not true, okay, it is saying whatever string you enter through the keyboard, it shouldn't be equal to by. Then only you are allowed to enter in this while loop. Otherwise, you would get out of this loop, and it is saying close all the connection and the reading buffer permission. Okay, you are not supposed to read anymore. Okay, so when each one of these, or either one of the client or server, they would write by. I have copy pasted the same thing over here. I have written all this chatting in the while loop. So whenever they write by, it will be stopped. Okay, so let me run. Just wait a second. Okay, so this is the folder. Let me little shell new tab. Okay, and Okay, so let me first remove because I have tested this, you know, client program. Oh, this is different. Just give me a second, so I'll check if I'm in the correct directory or not. Okay, this one I don't need. Okay, I need this and this one. Okay, so I think I'm in the correct directory now. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll compile the client program. Again, spelling mistake. Sorry. So this is after, you know, it means the client program is you know, compiled successfully. So this is also compiled successfully, I think. Now it is okay. So both the programs are compiled successfully. Let me open the you know, so the flow is the data should be written by the client. It means we should run the client first, or if we run the server, okay, let's understand what will happen theoretically. So if we run the client, as we need to write first of all, but the server is not up, so it will again throw the error of connection refused error. You must understand this thing, that if this line is not executed, then this port is not active. So in anyhow, if we run this program first of all, then this line will be executed and this port is activated, but it will wait over this line because this accept method would say I don't have any request from the client side. Okay, so it will go into the loop till there is a client request. So the best thing is to run the server program first of all and then the client program, even though the client would send the request, but there has to be a stable connection first of all, which will be done by the server socket class. So when only you run this server.java program. I hope this is clear. So here we are. So I'll run this Java server program first of all, because it will wait for the connection now. Now what I'll do, I'll call this client program. Okay. Now what happens? The client has sent this socket class has created, and at the server side, the connection is stable now, message is printed. So now they both are in the while loop. Okay, they are in the reading mode from the keyboard. Okay, they are now clear with this. Let me show you the code. Okay, so they have now reached to this while loop, and they are waiting for this read line. Okay, so the client is waiting for that, but where the server is actually, because I have not written anything on the buffer, then nothing can be, the server cannot read anything if there is nothing over the buffer. So if you try to call this read UTF method, then also you will go into the loop. So what is the best thing according to our notes is to write something over the client, and which will be read by the server. So what I'll do, I'll go to the client and I'll write something. Hello server. Okay, and this message will be there at the server side now. So it is saying, client is saying hello server. So I'll say hi. Hi. Hi client. And this message then should be at the client side. Okay, so it is saying server is saying hi client. So I'll say, how are you? Entering. Okay, and it is saying, client is saying, how are you? So I'll say, I am fine, and that would be at the client side. So I'll say, okay, I'll type buy. So it will say, okay, it is saying buy, so I'll also type buy. So it is saying I am out of the loop, and the client is also saying I am out of the loop. So this is the scenario. Okay, so I hope this is clear how this functionality is happening. First, we are writing from the client, and we are reading at the server, and then we are writing the same functionality we are performing over here. We are writing over here, and then we are reading at the client side. So this is the flow. You must follow this pattern, and you must also be aware why we have used this while statement over here. So guys, this is about today's lecture. We have done with the two-way communication, how this messages are being transferred to client to server and server to clients, and we have developed a good chat box using the socket and server socket programming. Okay, so thank you guys for today's lecture. We will discuss about your doubts in the doubt session. So my suggestion is to go through this lecture, and we will discuss about your doubts if you would be having any doubt. Okay, so thank you so much for today's lecture. It was a good day. Thank you. Have a good day.